byline for the entire show has been real, truthful, real, truthful. Even if it's somebody disintegrating into dust, what would it look like? How would it be? What would the remains look like? How would the body fall? How would the skull fall apart? How does the body die? Because it's not just FX and it's not just cool shit. It's characters feeling these things and experiencing them in the real world now, in a world where magic doesn't happen and paranormal things don't happen. So how do we assimilate it? So that's the brief.
So for me, I was really inspired by a lot of in-camera effects, like even going back to someone like Jean Cocteau, who would do all these beautiful in-camera effects without, you know, with little VFX work. Well, certainly in that time they didn't have those. So I did a lot of in-camera bleeding eyes.
And I'll be standing by and I run in and I actually drop a couple of drops in their eyes and it melds into the water in their own eyes, and after a couple of seconds a drop forms and it seems to appear like it's dropping in shot, you know, just coming out. They don't mind it actually, I think they quite enjoy it.
Scott Zero has been extraordinary in developing these effects and textures that is going to make it look as real as possible.
But the big one we've been working on is actually Carlisle's transformation, which is a reverse resurrection effect that is only seen once in the series, but really sets up, you know, what happens when you cross the threshold. The whole sequence actually only takes about 8 seconds for him to disappear. But the idea is that we would start with very gentle sort of live action augmentation to set up things like veins on the neck and subtle changes in the face. And then as we get near the end of the sequence, he's almost completely replaced with a CG character, essentially. It seems very simple on paper because you say, oh, we'll just shoot that in the dark and there'll be some dust and it'll all be simple. But when you actually go in there, it's actually been a good, you know, 2 or 3 months worth of work for 8 seconds. A strange thing happened near the end of production on the first episode, because we'd finished the Carlo effect, and Carlo's transformation actually continues right through to where his head actually comes apart. And there's an overhead shot of his head actually completely coming apart and crumbling to dust. And we finished it, but of course it was decided that was, as great as it was actually taking it too far into horror or too far into another genre. Because Glitch does enjoy having quite a unique little space cut out for itself as far as its story and its characters and the way that the series works. As soon as we went into that, we sort of became another show almost. So it was decided actually to pull back the last shot and actually let it be more mysterious what was happening. We think it's a really a cool transformation effect and something that's again sits quite well with the very strange world of Glitch.